Hello everyone, my name is Neeru and today we will be discussing SSC CGL Tier 1 paper according to the new pattern, and the paper code is 858. I will be doing the general awareness section with you and I'll be giving you detailed explanations from question number 26 to question number 50. Let's begin the general awareness section. First question: in which year did Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay write Anand Math? The question is, in which year did Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay write Anand Math? First, let us read about Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. He was a Bengali novelist. Anand Math, what is Anand Math? It's a Bengali novel written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay and it was published in the year 1882. And it is set in the background of Sanyasi rebellion of the 18th century and is considered a very, very important book in the history of Bengali and Indian literature. Very, very important because it talks about the Indian freedom struggle also. And this novel, it was banned by the Britishers at that time. But however, the ban was later lifted after India became free. And most important about it is that our national song Vande Mataram was first published in this novel. You can be given a lot of questions as to who wrote Anand Math. Bankim Chandra wrote. Which rebellion does it refer to? What is the background? The Sanyasi rebellion. And our national song Vande Mataram was published for the first time in which novel? Then the answer is Anand Math. And the answer to this question is 1882 C. Question number 27. The next question is question number 27. Metamorphic rocks originate from igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, both igneous and sedimentary, and finally none of these. What are metamorphic rocks? Metamorphic rocks are those rocks which have undergone a change due to temperature or due to pressure. Due to any of these two reasons, these rocks have undergone a change. And what are these rocks known as? They are known as metamorphic rocks. There is a rock cycle by which a sedimentary rock can change into a metamorphic rock can change into a sedimentary rock, and so on. See, igneous rocks are those which are formed by the lava or magma which has come out from the earth. And after that, when these igneous rocks, they undergo change due to temperature and pressure, they become metamorphic rocks. And these same rocks, metamorphic rocks, when they will be carried away by running water and deposited somewhere else, later they will form sedimentary rocks. So this is basically the rock cycle where one kind of a rock can be converted into another. Cooling and crystallization will form igneous rocks. So metamorphic rocks can be formed by igneous, sedimentary or existing metamorphic rocks. So for question number 2, answer is C, both igneous and sedimentary rocks. This is going to be the answer for question number 27. Question number 28, which act provided India to become an independent state? Which act laid down for the independence of India? The Indian Independence Act of 1949, Indian Independence Act of 1946, Indian Independence Act of 1947, or none of the above? Question number 28. Which year did we become independent? We became independent in 1947, and this itself is the answer. The answer is C, Indian Independence Act of 1947. Now, what is the Indian Independence Act of 1947? Let's see a bit about that. The Indian Independence Act was based on Mountbatten Plan of 3rd June 1947. Lord Mountbatten was sent to India by the British government and he was told that he can take the decision which was required to be taken on the spot. He was given full powers, and Mountbatten Plan of 3rd June 1947 was passed by British Parliament on July 5th, 1947. And what was this Mountbatten Plan? It clearly laid down that India would be divided and two new countries would be formed now, India and Pakistan. And there would be a boundary commission. There would be a boundary commission which would determine the boundary line between these two countries. And since this boundary commission was headed by Sir Cyril Radcliffe, that is why the boundary line is known as the Radcliffe line. And the authority of the British Crown over princely states would come to an end, and after that they would be free to join either India or Pakistan, or they could even remain independent. and the constituent assemblies of both India and Pakistan, they were free to make constitutions of their respective countries. So where was all this? This was there in the Indian Independence Act of 1947, according to which India was granted freedom. Okay, this was all about the act. Next is question number 29. The standard time of a country differs from the GMT or the Greenwich Mean Time by in multiples of. Okay, question number 29. The standard time of a country differs from the GMT in multiples of. My options are 2 hours, 1 hour, half hour or 4 minutes. The answer is half hour, half an hour. The Greenwich Mean Time is the time which is there on 0 degree longitude, and then after that there are longitudes on the east and west, 1 degree east, 2 degree east, 3 degree east and so on. Similarly, 1 degree west, 2 degree west, 3 degree west and so on. For every 1 degree that you move, there is a difference of 4 minutes. Like for example, India, we have taken the 82.5 degree east as the standard timeline for India. And basically for countries, the time differs from the Greenwich Mean Time in multiples of half an hour. So the standard time differs from GMT in multiples of half an hour, and countries which have vast longitudinal extent go for more than one time zone, and such countries are countries like Canada, countries like USA, etc. Question number 30. The next one is question number 30. The market regulation system was introduced by. So who introduced the market regulation system? This is our question. Who introduced the market regulation system? The market regulation system was introduced by Alauddin Khilji. Very, very important ruler in the history of India. Very, very important ruler, and introduced a lot of reforms, and among those reforms, his market reforms are very, very well known. Question number 3. He wanted to establish a huge empire. He has wanted to establish a huge empire, and he is also known as Sikandar Sani. He is known as Sikandar Sani. He wanted to establish a huge empire, and for establishing a huge empire, he needed a huge army. He needed a huge army, and he wanted to pay his soldiers in cash. And he wanted to pay them the bare minimum salary so that they could survive. And if he was paying them the bare minimum salaries, he needed to control the prices. It is not possible that the prices are very high and he is paying a bare minimum salary. Therefore, he strictly regulated the markets. He strictly regulated the markets, and he established 4 separate markets for different commodities. For example, the first market was the grain market. Second was the market for manufactured goods. Third for general merchandise, and fourth was for horses, cattle, slaves, etc. He even fixed the price of each and every commodity. He fixed the price for each and every commodity, and after that, each market was put under the charge of a shahana or controller of market. And all the merchants were to be registered. All the people who traded in the market, they were to be registered. And the Sultan used to receive daily reports about the market from 3 independent sources. Firstly, from the Shahana, who was the controller of market. Next, he had spies or intelligent officers known as Barids. And then even other spies known as Munshis. And very strict punishment was laid down for cheating and underweighing. It is said that he used to send small children and illiterate people to go and purchase something. And then if the weight was less, he would cut off flesh from the shopkeeper's body. So he was extremely strict. And Shehnai Mandi was appointed to keep a strict vigil. There was also provision for rationing during famine, drought and scarcity of food grains. And the system is said to be so effective that not even in times of scarcity or in times of droughts and floods did the prices of commodities rise. Horse trade was monopoly of Afghans and Multanis, and middlemen sold them in the market. Alauddin did away with the intermediaries and asked the merchants to sell the horses directly to Diwan-e-Arz, and Diwan-e-Arz was the military department of the king. It was the military department of the kingdom.
So that was all about Alauddin Khilji, who laid down many market reforms for the betterment of his kingdom. Next is question number 31. Question number 31 says, which one of the following literary works was not written by R.K. Narayanan? Malgudi Days, Swami and His Friends, Guide, and finally Gardener. Question number 31, answer is The Gardener. The Gardener was written by Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore. Let us take a look at the books written by R.K. Narayan. R.K. Narayan, Swami and His Friends, one of his very famous books, The Bachelor of Arts. Then we had The Guide, a movie also has been made on it. Swami, The Bachelor of Arts, The Guide, Mr. Sampat, Waiting for the Mahatma, The Vendor of Sweets, A Tiger for Malgudi, The World of Nagraj, Malgudi Days, Dark Rooms, English Teacher, Financial Expert, The Man Eater of Malgudi, Painter of Signs, Talkative Man, Grandmother's Tale. This is not a complete exhaustive list. Apart from these, there are also other books written by him, but these are the famous ones. That is the reason I have included them here. Question number 32. Blizzards are the characteristic feature of where do blizzards occur? Now, first and foremost, what are blizzards? Blizzards are, here it is given, severe snowstorms. Severe snowstorms in which even wind is going to be there and a lot of snow is going to be blown from here to there. They have two features. One is strong sustained winds blowing at 56 km per hour. And the next is these storms continue for a very long period of time. Sometimes even more than 3 to 4 hours or even more than that. This is the bare minimum. And obviously they are going to occur in those regions where there is going to be snow. North America, in North America, blizzards happen often in northeastern states and in the provinces of Canada. Here for question number 32, blizzards even occur in the Antarctic region. Answer for question number 32 is C, Antarctic region. Question number 33, why is India a republic? What do we mean by a republic? What is the meaning of the word republic? R-E-P-U-B-L-I-C, republic. It's a democratic country. It's a parliamentary democracy. Head of the state is elected for a definite period. All of these. Simple answer, a republic is going to be that state or that country where the head is going to be elected by the people. A republic is a sovereign state or country which is organized with a form of government in which power resides in elected individuals representing the citizen body, and government leaders exercise power according to rule of law. So for question number 33, my answer is C. Question number 34, heat resistant variety of glass is? My options are Pyrex glass, hard glass, flint glass, none of these. Now, heat resistant glass, what is it? The answer is Pyrex glass. Question number 34A. Now, the raw material which is required for manufacturing ordinary glass is sodium carbonate, calcium carbonate and silica. These are the basic raw materials. And Pyrex glass is highly heat resistant. In fact, you can keep it in the microwave oven and nothing is going to happen to it. In ordinary glass, silica is the main constituent, but in Pyrex glass, some of the silica is replaced by boron oxide. Please underline this. You can be given a question as to what is used in Pyrex glass that makes it heat resistant. The answer is going to be boron oxide. And this boron oxide expands very little when heated. Thus, Pyrex glass does not crack on strong heating. And Pyrex glass, it is also known as borosilicate glass. It has a very high melting point and is resistant to many chemicals. Laboratory equipment and ovenware are made of Pyrex glass. Question number 34. Next is question number 35. What is the name of electronic communication network of the RBI? Question number 35. Answer is RBI Net. C. RBI Net is your answer. Question number 36. The body temperature is regulated by pituitary gland. Correct the spelling of pituitary. It's an error here. Hypothalamus, pineal gland or thyroid gland. These are my options. And here we have put a picture here. See, we have, where do we have hypothalamus? Here is the hypothalamus and here is the pituitary gland. Okay, now hypothalamus, it's a part of the brain and it controls many things like thirst, hunger, body temperature, sleep and release of hormones. So hypothalamus is going to control the body temperature. Answer for question number 36 is B. What is the pituitary gland? Here is the pituitary gland, as you can see, smaller sized one. Here it is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is pea-sized structure located at the base of the brain. And what is its important function? Pituitary gland is a part of the endocrine system and it produces some important critical hormones which control many functions of the body. So pituitary gland and hypothalamus, very very important and located in our head. Question number 37. The Balwant Rai Mehta Committee was associated with. What is the Balwant Rai Mehta Committee associated with? Industrial policy, banking reforms, Panchayati Raj or center-state relations? It is associated with Panchayati Raj. It is associated with Panchayati Raj, Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. Balwant Rai Mehta Committee, this was a committee appointed by Government of India in January 1957. And what was the main work of this committee? It had to examine the working of community development programs. And the head of this committee was Balwant Rai Mehta. That is why it is known as Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. And later it recommended establishing a scheme of democratic decentralization. What is decentralization? When power is given at the lower level, you do not keep all the powers concentrated in one head or in the center. So later this system of democratic decentralization, it came to be known as the Panchayati Raj, and the main aim of Panchayati Raj system is to settle the local problems locally and make people politically conscious. Question number 37. Question number 38. Who has recently been appointed as first non-Navy officer to head the Coast Guard? This is my question. Question number 38. Who has recently been appointed as first non-Navy officer to head the Coast Guard? Options are Ratan Tata, then we have Trilok Negi, Rajeshwar Singh, Rajendra Singh. These are my four options and answer is Rajendra Singh. Rajendra Singh appointed as first non-Navy officer to head the Coast Guard. Question number 38. Question number 39. Which one of the following Grand Slam titles is known as Roland Garros title? R-O-L-L-A-N-D, Roland Garros. Who was Roland Garros? It's the name of a person. And he was a French aviator and fighter pilot during World War I. And he died at a very young age. And while he was studying in Paris, he used to go to this, place where there was a tennis center and he used to watch all matches there. So Roland George Garros, that is his full name. He was an early French aviator and a fighter pilot during World War I. He went to a tennis center regularly, religiously, when he was studying in Paris. And at this very place, the French Open tournament is held. So, in honor of this person, Roland Georges Garros, the French Open is also known as Roland Garros title. Okay. So, he went to a tennis center religiously when he was studying in Paris, and it is named after him in the 20s. The stadium accommodates the French Open, one of the four Grand Slam tennis tournaments. French Open, named after the French aviator Roland Garros. It is a premier clay court tennis championship event in the world. Next is AVN. What is AVN? AVN is made up of neurons, veins, muscles or capillaries. AVN is it's a disease. A vascular necrosis, that's a full form. A vascular necrosis, it is a condition that occurs when there is loss of blood to the bone, because bone is a living tissue and all living tissues will require regular supply of blood. So an interruption of the blood causes the bone to die. So for question number 40, the answer is going to be C. Question number 40, answer will be C. 41. The light of the sun reaches the earth in about how much time? The light of the sun reaches the earth from about how much time? The sunlight from their sun travels at the speed of light, the fastest thing that you can imagine. And photons emitted from the surface of the sun need to travel across vacuum of space to reach our eyes. Approximately 8 minutes are taken. To be precise, 8 minutes and 20 seconds are going to be taken for the light of the sun to reach us. So here in this question, what is the answer? Answer is B, 8 minutes. Question number 42. Goa was captured by the Portuguese in which year? Goa was captured by the Portuguese in which year? 1508, 1608, 1510 or 1610? Question number 42. Answer will be 1510. And why is the answer 1510? Let us see that also. Did the Portuguese ever plan to capture Goa? No. The Portuguese conquest of Goa occurred in 1510. The Portuguese were the first to come to India. First, Vasco da Gama came in the year 1498 and he realized that he can make a, when the Portuguese can make a lot of money by taking spices from India and selling them in Europe. Afonso de Alberesque. Goa was not among the cities that Alberesque had received troops, had ordered troops to conquer. Initially, there were no plans to conquer Goa, but Goa was attacked on the invitation of a local chieftain whose name is Thimaiya, who was an exiled Hindu from Goa. And Thimaiya had received appeals from Hindu population of Goa to relieve them from Muslim rule, and it was then that Thimaiya approached the Portuguese and finally Goa was attacked. And Goa at that time was a prosperous trading port on the Indian coast. Question number 43. Who was the chairman of the drafting committee of the constitution? The answer is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Question number 43. This was pretty simple. That is the reason that we call our constitution Ambedkar constitution, because he was the chairman of the drafting committee. Question number 43. 44. The data collected for national income estimation is conducted in India by... Who collects the data for the national income estimation? The answer is National Sample Survey Organization, or which is now better known as National Sample Survey Office. So NSSO, this is the one, answer is C. This is an organization under Ministry of Statistics of the Government of India, and it is the largest organization in India conducting regular socio-economic surveys. Question number 44. Question number 45. Where are MIG engines assembled? Koraput, Nasik, Bangalore or Uzar? Question number 45. The answer is going to be Koraput. K-O-R-A-P-U-T. Here you have Hindustan Aeronautics Limited located here, and it is here that MIG engines are assembled in Koraput. 46. Question number 46. Which of the following is a disk operating system, DOS command, list, change, duplicate or format? Question number 46. The most famous disk operating commands are DIR, lists the contents of the folder, format, formats the given drive and type. So here we have format. Answer for question number 46 is going to be D. Question number 47. Next question. Dioptor is the unit of, what is dioptor the unit of? Power of lens, focal length of a lens, light intensity or sound intensity? A dioptor is a unit to measure the optical power of a lens or curved mirror. It measures the optical power of a lens or curved mirror, which is equal to the reciprocal of the focal length. So since it measures the optical power of a lens or curved mirror, answer is going to be A. Question number 47. 48. Which one of the following groups of gases contribute to greenhouse effect? What is greenhouse effect? Greenhouse effect is the constant rise in temperature of the earth. That is known as the greenhouse effect. And why is the temperature constantly rising? The temperature is constantly rising because there are not too many vehicles on the roads, there are too many factories, all these give out carbon dioxide, and carbon dioxide is a heat retaining gas. That is the reason that the temperature of the earth is rising. Question number 48. Which of the following group of gases contribute greenhouse gases? Carbon dioxide and methane, ammonia and ozone, carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide, or carbon tetrafluoride and nitrous oxide. The main greenhouse gases are water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and ozone. These are the four gases: water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and ozone. Now we have carbon dioxide and methane here. Ammonia is not, so this will get eliminated. Sulfur dioxide is not, so it will get eliminated. This one will get eliminated. So for question number 48, answer is A. 49. Cross demand expresses the functional relationship between demand and prices of related commodities, demand and income, demand and price, demand and supply. These are my four options. Firstly, let us understand what is cross demand. In economics, cross elasticity of demand or cross price elasticity of demand, it measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded for a good to a change in the price of another good. Now I'll just explain to you. Suppose a buffalo is there for sale and a cow is there for sale. If I increase the price of the buffalo, suppose it was initially being sold for 20,000 rupees, now I increase it to 22,000, will that have an impact on the sale of the cow? Okay, that is what it means. It says it measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded for a good to a change in the price of another good. Okay, if the price of tea increases, what will be the impact on the price of coffee? That is what what do people do? They will compare the prices of two commodities which can replace one another, okay, and then they are going to purchase it. Now, cross demand expresses the functional relationship between demand and prices of related commodities, demand and income, demand and price, or demand and supply. Another example, if the price of dairy milk increases, okay, the price of dairy milk increases, then do you think the price of another chocolate of another brand, like for example take Kit Kat, like I have written here, or some other, will the sale of that increase? So this is what is the cross demand relationship. For question number 49, answer is A. If other things being constant, cross demand expresses the relationship between demand for good A due to change in the price of its related good B. So question number 49 is A, demand and prices of related commodities. Question number 50, the last one to be done here. The world's longest and deepest rail tunnel has recently opened in which country? Current news, in 2016 only this has taken place. The world's longest and deepest rail tunnel has officially opened in Switzerland. After almost two decades of construction work, 57 kilometer twin bore Gotthard based tunnel will provide a high speed link between under the Swiss Alps between northern and southern Europe, and it is expected that it is going to change the transportation system of Europe completely. That was the last question to be done. For question number 50, my answer is B. I wish you all the very, very best and thank you for watching this lecture. Thank you.